Hello and welcome to something slightly different from the ordinary action themed games that I usually put on the channel. Trailblazer by Sean Sutton, or whatever, however it's pronounced. Sutton, I don't know. Of course he was later well known for the Lotus Esprit series, specifically on the Amiga. But him and Andrew Morris made quite a few great games. Not to forget Kickstart and Kickstart 2. But Trailblazer. You play a ball that bounces along a track. It doesn't bounce unless you want it to, but the aim of the game is simple. Go through the different stages as safely as possible. You have multiple different ways to play. You can play a one-player arcade, two-player arcade, one-player trial, two-player match, or play versus robot. I don't like playing versus robot, I find it extremely annoying. Ideally, this is best enjoyed playing two players. But in arcade mode, you have 7 jumps per level, and you can carry up to 2 jumps on to the next level, to a maximum of 9 jumps. The different squares, as is being described in the scroll text. Red squares slows you down, green squares speed you up, blue squares makes you jump, purple squares knock you back, and white squares are warp squares. If I get a chance to show you off, you can, or show it off even, show you off, I can show you off! Wow. You'll see what I mean. It's definitely a warp. So, without further ado, let's get started. Easy going. Hurry. And I screwed up. The first chance I got, I managed to screw up. I am so good. I actually expected to bounce on that one, but I did not. Hooray! Level 1 complete. I want a cookie. Woolly jumper. Okay. Warp. Come on, get through, get through, get through. Oops. Nope, didn't get through. The sequence to make that series of that pattern even is to jump first, and then you don't jump yourself, but you go over the square. And when you hit the middle one, you slow down as you hit it. That should send you to the last one perfectly, which I managed to screw up royally. I'm very, very good at screwing things up. In case you doubt what I say, you can watch the rest of my videos. But I just like to share games that I, in one way or another, have enjoyed at one point or another, or still enjoy. And Trailblazer is definitely one of them. It's simple, but it has that addictiveness that you can't explain. Every 3 levels you get a bonus game, which is basically Simon Says, copy what the computer is doing from your current location. So that would be ding and hey, but that only gives bonus points, so we don't care about that. Meet the Cyan Zone. Oh yeah, the Cyan Zones. Well, that was a short warp. The Cyan Zones are evil, evil... Let's talk in more focusing. Come on. Ugh. Because what the Cyan Zone will do is it will reverse your left and right control of your joystick.
P
which is not so bad when you got a long stretch of it and you're prepared for it, but there will be levels where they are mixed in at random, which makes it a bit beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. If you get to a level with a warp on, you gain a huge time bonus for the following level, or for the following levels, depending on how well you play. I just get screwed by the fact that the Sand Zone actually changes your controls around. But whatever time you have remaining on a level is carried on to the next one. So the faster you go through a level, the more time you will have. Make sense? So of course, if you go through with a warp, you will complete the levels rather quickly. You can't complete every level with a warp square on with the full warp, because it will run out. But it gives you a huge boost if you can keep going. Mostly you just want to pick a direction and don't hold down fire to jump and hope that you get through, because it becomes rather manic to try and control the ball. Return of the Sand Zone. Oh dear. Oh, wait. Come on. Almost, but not quite. And I got no jumps left, so trying to jump is pointless. Close. Nice little time bonus to get. Looks rather funny when you play with another player and that player hits a warp square. That ball just takes off. And a minor thing, but something I think is worth mentioning, is that this game definitely shows off how fast the Commodore 64 can actually scroll, even in a pseudo 3D, and with two players there's no slowdowns or delays or anything at all. So all you need is someone who knows how to program something at a decent quality. I suppose this is not exactly the most graphically intensive game you could find on any system, but graphics is only part of it. If the game is not fun to play, then what's the point? You're playing games to have fun, or to be excited, or things like that. And this game can, in its own way, be adrenaline pumping. I'm not sure I should have hit that proper square. Maybe I can save. No, I can't. This is all about remembering patterns, and it's been quite a while since I played this last time. Come on, come on. It's actually quite interesting how much you can remember. Bonus game. But here looks about right, doesn't it? No? No. Okay. Revenge of the Sion Zone. Okay. Evil. Nasty. Keep on moving. Okay. This level. Come on, get through, get through, get through. Nope. It's still not bad. Still got 32 seconds. Carrying on to next level. You get a base time of 30 seconds per level. So, and some levels are very nasty. So if you haven't got a huge buildup of time, you can't be up with the famous creek. And someone broke your paddle. Cruel, cruel, cruel. So, tempting to be too close to the edge. So, not exactly the most complicated game in the world, but keep on hopping. Okay, I'm hopping away. Oh dear. Even if I make this, nope. And there's a warp square there. It's just evil. It's just mocking you. Do you want this warp square? Do you? Do you? Tough. You can actually make that pattern if you have more skill than I have, which wouldn't take much. Come on, come on. Idiot! There are days where you wake up when you wake up in the morning and feel stupid. I think this is one of those days for me. So as you can see, this game can give you a lot of time, but it can also take it away just as quick. That being said, we are on level N at the moment, and I think U is the last letter in the. Not exactly sure, to be honest. The nasty part of this zone is the fact that it changes between cyan and normal. Come on. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Ah. Come on! Wee! Combination one! Why did it give me that much time? Okay, ah! If it suddenly gives you 50 seconds out of nowhere, then there's usually a reason for it. How to play computer games in 101, don't watch my channel. Oh lordy. I am not going to make it past this level. Nope. A game over. So there you have it. That was a look at the Trailblazer. A game I repeatedly have called enjoyable, and it is. It is a remembrance of the time when you were sitting a bunch of guys with one joystick or two joysticks in front of a computer playing one game. and having a lot of fun doing that. Having many tournaments and things like that. So it's not just because I'm old and I'm reflecting on the past, and it's not because I think that yesteryear was better, but sometimes I do miss the time when we're just... Online gaming is cool and all that, but there's a level of enjoyment from sitting in the same room, just having fun with a single game, or multiple games, whatever takes your fancy, of course, but yeah. That is unfortunately a bygone era, which I think people would develop good relations by gaming together, or make horrible enemies of each other. My brother and I have had many a minor fight. This is a game I'm going to cover at one point, and then I will tell you an interesting story relation to that game. But that's for another time. As for now, thanks for watching, take care, and see you again. Bye bye.